Congratulations to the St. Andrew Prep family. We have another crop of youngsters moving up on the educational ladder. Let us go to God in prayer. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, how we thank you for your loving kindness, which is better than life itself. Before any of us was formed in our mother's wombs, you knew us. Before any of us was born, you had a purpose for us in mind. Your grace is beyond all measure, your wisdom beyond all telling. We thank you for blessing our St. Andrew Preparatory School family with good leadership, a godly board of management, insightful principal and academic staff, faithful administrative and ancillary staff, loyal parents, and mentally astute children. As you have blessed us in the past, may your blessings continue to be with us. O God, we pray for these students who will now transition to another level of learning. May their fertile minds always bear the fruits of discipline and diligence. May their souls be nimble enough to hold to your values as they navigate these changing times. May their hearts be tender enough to yield to your promptings of goodness and godliness. May their lives be resilient enough to soar, to take hold of the opportunities and the possibilities that exist in life. Since you hold our future in your hands, remind us all of the constancy of your shepherding care. May we forever walk in the light of faith, knowing that we dwell beneath the protection of your eternal wings. So guard, guide, bless, and keep us all, we pray, that we may never flag in zeal, but rather be aglow in the Spirit, serving you always. We pray these things in and through the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen.
First scripture reading is taken from Psalm 121. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. The second scripture reading is taken from Isaiah 40 verse 31. But those who trust in the Lord will find new strength. They will soar high on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Mrs. Pat Sinclair McCullough, Madam Chairlady, Board of Governors, Dr. Andre Dyer, our Principal, Mrs. Bethania Edwards, our Vice Principal, our most esteemed guest speaker and past Principal, Mrs. Janet Walsh Davis, parents, guardians, teachers, fellow students, and friends, welcome to Family Prayers. Family Prayers is an annual school leaving service for the grade 6 students here at St. Andrew Preparatory School. In keeping with our theme, I am resilient and ready to soar, we take this opportunity to thank everyone, especially our teachers, parents, guardians, family members, and friends who supported and guided us on this flight. You have been the wind beneath our wings, and with your continued efforts and God's blessings, we will soar to greater heights.
Our time spent at St. Andrew Preparatory has taught us many lessons. They will be with us for the rest of our lives. We are grateful to all who have helped us along this journey and will forever treasure our time spent here. The past 2 years were very challenging with online classes and separated us from our teachers and friends. We, however, through dedication and resilience, were able to overcome our many obstacles. With guidance from our teachers and parents, we still manage to work, play, and learn together. This pandemic has proven that we are indeed resilient and ready to soar.
Today, we stand here as proud school leavers of St. Andrew Preparatory School, Class of 2021. It is a bittersweet moment for all of us, but we are overjoyed and basking in this accomplishment.
To our teachers, families, and friends who join us remotely from a safe distance to celebrate with us, you have done your part in shaping our minds. Allow us now to shine and make you all proud. It is with great pleasure that we welcome you today to Family Prayers and trust that you'll enjoy the program.
Our theme this year, I Am Resilient, I Soar, speaks distinctively about our guest speaker. Mrs. Janet Walsh Davies, the former principal of St. Andrew Preparatory School, hails from the parish of Portland. She was an active and loved child with a strong personality and self-will. Throughout her life, she was destined to succeed. She desired it, dreamt it, pursued it, and achieved it. From an early age, she desired to be a teacher. She dreamt of that goal and pursued the diploma, bachelor's degree, and master's degree to become proficient at her craft. This enabled her to work both in Jamaica and overseas in the education system. She is now an education officer in the Ministry of Education, Jamaica. However, she operates as a lecturer, educational and instructional leader, as well as program coordinator with 25 years teaching experience. Mrs. Walsh Davies is a mother of three, and they will all agree with me that she pushes herself to go beyond the call of duty, and she encourages everyone around her along that same path. She puts her heart into everything she does. The SAP staff will remember those 2 a.m. emails with detailed plans on a project, as well as conference calls inquiring on issues or situations they may be facing at that time. Oh yes, she tried to mother everyone around her. We have indeed been blessed to have met and worked alongside her. Our graduating class today have been prodigies of her wisdom and experiences over the years. To take the words from Shaggy, never underestimate the strength of a woman. This woman, Walsh Davies. It is with great honor that I present to you today our esteemed guest speaker, Mrs. Janet Walsh Davies.
Dennis Wortley said, and I quote, "Our limitations and success will be based most often on our own expectations of ourselves. What the mind dwells on, the body acts on," end of quote. Master of Ceremonies, Chairman of the Board of Governors, members of the board, principal, senior management team, other members of staff, distinguished guests, parents and guardians, graduating class of 2021, good afternoon. It is a privilege for me to be here with you as you celebrate such a significant milestone, indicative of your readiness to soar through resilience. My charge to you this afternoon is to never settle, but to continue exceeding expectations regardless of the challenges. It is said that you can't spell challenge without change. And with this knowledge, we must welcome a thought process which echoes, what my mind conceives and believes it can achieve. Familiar words, aren't they, graduates? Yes, they are, because over the years, Reverend Mullings, one of our school chaplains, would always share that with you. Thank you, Reverend Mullings. If it doesn't challenge you, it won't change you. Life as we see it goes through a continuous motion of changes and transitions. And it's when such movement of your attention, you grow as an individual of excellence, developing mentally, spiritually, and socially. With this new you, because of your experience, knowledge, and empowerment, you will go beyond normal, exceeding in whatever you do, as your foundation was already cemented. You realize now that you need to adjust and reframe your mind to take on this new norm. And in doing so, it is a new chapter being acted upon. But not to be denied, neither marketing effort, social media buzzword, nor any disease can be a substitute for you and your uniqueness. Like success, failure is many things to many people. With a positive mental attitude, failure is a learning experience, a rung on the ladder, and a plateau on which to get your thoughts, energies, and mindset working together beyond the challenges, knowing you are equipped and ready to soar. This pandemic has taught you the true meaning of resilience. So don't allow the noise of other people's opinion to drown out your inner voice. And more importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow know what you truly want to become. As you head off to high school, please ensure that you make wise choices, as the choices you make will follow you for a lifetime. Be a good friend. Appreciate your friends and solve your problems in a creative manner. Even in an abusive and painful situation, forgive, heal, and find peace. Find the humor in it and laugh about it and move on. And never forget to say thanks to those who helped you along the way, especially God. Choose your friends wisely as you strive to exceed expectations. You will need all these skills wherever you live and work in the world. As transitioners, I implore you to use the knowledge, life skills, and values bestowed at this school to guide you throughout the transition process during your quest for further education. There are various educational programs at your disposal, as the information and knowledge era has been changing the world physically, socially, culturally, economically, and otherwise. I challenge you to become a part of this competitive edge by becoming critical thinkers, problem solvers, communicators, collaborators, lifelong learners, and stewards of the environment. You must prepare yourselves to function globally and internationally. The COVID-19 experience has taught you well. Parents, guardians, well-wishers, I praise you for the hard work and sacrifices rendered in an effort for your children to be at the sojourn of their educational landscape. I am aware that the emotional, financial, and physical obligations were not always easy. However, you stuck to the task and ensured that your children excelled at all costs. I applaud and encourage you to continue being the main support system for your children at all grade levels. As Jamaica prepares students to be 21st century learners, parents and the wider society must be integral in the business of education. Parents, as your children transition to the next level of their education, you cannot drop the ball. Times will get harder. More resources will be required. The level of difficulty of their studies will increase. But you must not relent. What the mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. Education is a way of life. The Ministry of Education, Youth and Information continues to applaud our educational institutions for empowering students to achieve their full potential. High commendations must be extended. Despite the challenges faced by this school family, the principal and staff of this noble institution ensured that they were never daunted in providing the best quality educational opportunities for their students. School family, today, we continue to applaud you for your consistent efforts. St. Andrew Preparatory School continue to be a beacon in the business of education and lifelong learning. Continue to provide a comprehensive and solid foundation to each individual who seeks learning opportunities within your gates. Teachers, principal, board members, past students, and educational partners, continue to be steadfast in your support. Graduates, you will become great leaders in the future. As you venture out to lead, you'll be faced with challenges much greater than before. But I urge you to persevere despite the circumstances. Do not give up. When you get to the end of your rope, tie a knot and hang on. Dedicating yourselves to seizing the numerous opportunities that the schools will provide for you to learn and grow, so that you will each discover your own potential. Remember the investment that your parents made. Step forward then with zeal and enthusiasm to make them proud. May you never lose sight of the ideals that were instilled in you. And do not for one moment forget the experiences that have made your days at the school a memorable one. Instead, take the opportunity to dedicate yourself to making your next experience even better. Build on your strengths to forge ahead while upholding your values and principles. In charting a new trajectory, choose your pathway and stay the course. On your shoulders lies not just your own future, but the hope of the nation. I charge you, therefore, to go and make yourselves productive citizens, ready for the fourth industrial revolution. Take pride in how far you have come, and have faith in how far you can go. I congratulate you on reaching this milestone. God be with you all on your next phase of life, and may we never forget that you are resilient and you are ready to soar. The world of learning awaits you. Stake your claim. God bless you on your journey. Thank you.
Grade 6, Ramsey.
Class of 2021. Boys and girls of Grade 6 Ramsey, my lovely children, we have certainly had a memorable journey together. We have laughed, we have cried, we have had some heated discussions and at times conflicting opinions. Through it all, we have come to understand and respect each other. As you go off to high school, I feel like a mother bird who has given her nestlings all the practice needed to develop the strong muscles necessary to flap their wings to their fullest potential. Now, with confidence and trust in God, I give you that final nudge from the nest, and I beam with pride as I watch you soar to great heights. You will have doubts and uncertainties that will sometimes cause you to feel like you are going to come crashing to the ground. However, always remember that you are never alone. God is always with you. You can trust and depend on Him. Remember to put Christ first in everything. Be honest, be obedient, be respectful. And most of all, remember Philippians 4 verse 13. I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. Boys and girls, my lovely children, don't stress. Just pray and give your best, and then let God do the rest.
Talked all night about the rest of our lives. Where we're gonna be when we turn 25. Grade 6, Morrison.
To my dear students, this year has been an awesome and memorable journey. There were happy and sad moments, but through it all, you remained positive and worked as a team. Together, you were able to destroy barriers, build bridges, and close gaps. You displayed tenacity, strength, dedication, and most importantly, commitment. I am proud of all your achievements and will miss the many requests to lower my voice, us singing during lessons, and your out-of-the-box and never-ending questions. As your journey continues into high school, remember, believe in yourself, never give up, and always trust God. For you are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that you should walk in them. Therefore, be not afraid to grow slowly. Be afraid of standing still, because whatever seems hardest is your greatest opportunity for growth. And you never lose. You either win or learn. So never stop trying. There is no farewell for me, Grade 6 Morrison, as wherever you go, you will always remain in my heart.
Hey, give thanks for life, give thanks for life. Chimney, chimney, today my rise like the sunrise, my bright and my upright. No one can break my vibes. I may not care who I fight, I know I criticize, I'm on a higher heights. So you can say what you want to and do what you want to, it's no concern to me. Because I have my own vision, my dip on my own mission to rule my destiny. Oh, it's my day to do anything I want to. Space. I'm in a different place, different face, moving on my way. So if you feel like a champion and nothing can go wrong, this one is your song. Hey, put away your troubles, put away your worries, help me sing along. Oh, it's my day to do anything I want to. It's my time and I'll use it anyway. Responsible for every action. It's all mine. My day, my time, my life. Out there, feeling alive, feeling a vibe, and nothing can stop me. I don't care what they think or what they say about me. Look out, world, here we come, up and running. And all I'm saying is, it's my for every action.
It was a year ago, we listened to our teacher in class, engaged each other, excited much, through activities, laughter, and serious moments as we learnt together.
We looked forward to our lunchtime. Oh yes, the bell would ring. We would take off to the canteen for our lunch and headed to our favorite spot on the orchard.
Yes, we owned it, our school, our home away from home, our retreat. And then, a year ago, it all changed. Our friendships hanging in the distance, the challenges of learning with a new style of teaching.
A year ago, our kitchens, living rooms, and bedrooms became our classrooms. Nothing prepared us, nothing could. A year ago, the world changed.
We became a mass race, a mass society, and some of us a mass brain, trying to figure it all out.
Just a year ago, none of what we knew as normal existed.
Our friends, hugs, laughter, the little things we took for granted are now in the distance.
Our school has ended. Just so, and we all had to adjust.
A year ago, we lost loved ones. A year ago, families uprooted. A year ago, we had to learn to adjust. It was just a year ago.
We had to learn to be of support to each other.
Our teachers were champions. Our parents safeguarded us. All of this was just a year ago.
And as we step forward into this new chapter of our lives, we carry with us all that we have learned.
For our most important day, we remain adjustable, open, and ready to take off.
Continuing to soar.
It was just a year ago.
Grade 6, Matt Dermott.
To my students, it seemed that only yesterday you were stumbling through the doors of your classroom, anxiously awaiting what was in store. I watched as some of you confidently or nervously shared bits and pieces of yourselves with your new classmates and new teacher. You shared your expectations and what you hoped to achieve at the end of your primary school career. I had the opportunity to teach many of you in grade 5, and it was during that year I watched you face the battles and hurdles of a worldwide pandemic. You were placed in a position many could barely grasp, but you shifted your sails and persevered through it all. As we entered the grade 6 year, together we navigated unknown territories. We found strength where there were weaknesses, and you became masters at finding your way through the many learning platforms. I have learned many tricks and methods myself, but on many occasions, you, my students, were my greatest teachers. Grade 6 has been an interesting year, one filled with many accomplishments and successes. I am proud of the way you have all stayed the fight, grown academically, and have become more confident in every step of the way. When news of PEP came, you handled the surprises and changes, and that made me smile to see how much you had matured. I have learned so much from you, and hope that you too have learned from experiences we have had over the past months. We have laughed, cried, and rejoiced together. I will always remember occasions where you, in some ways, extended a helping hand to a classmate, played your part as a student, and offered support to your teacher. I have one charge for you. Go forward now, with hope in your hearts that you were born with everything you need to be you. Find your place and stand out. Make a difference. Be who you can be and be the best of that person. Always remembering, with Christ in your vessel, not only can you smile at the storm, but you will make the impossible possible. I believe in you. I wish so much that all good things did not come to an end. It is always so hard to say goodbye and let go. So let us not say goodbye. Instead, let us say, see you later. Walk good.
Like the caterpillar that becomes a butterfly, you too were born to fly.
I was born with everything I need to be me, with wings inside my mind to set me free. I know I've got vision more than my eyes can see, and I know I rule my destiny.
So no matter how hard you try,
no, you can never change my mind. I know if caterpillars can fly, so can I.
So can I. So can I. Yeah.
I know if caterpillars can fly, so can I.
Hey, watch out now. This a favorite caterpillar member say you can't fly. Don't watch no mosquito or no sandfly. Don't sit down and complain. Get up and try. Say the word, the whole universe comply. I
work on your goals and build them.
Take time and sharpen your skills them. And your dreams don't make no one kill them. Them soon see your wings them.
And no matter how you try, there's a fact they can't deny.
If caterpillars can fly,
so can I.
So can I.
So can I.
Yeah. I know if caterpillars can fly,
so can I.
So can I. Yeah. Yes, I know that I can fly. For I've learned the laws of life.
I know that. Caterpillars can fly,
so can I. So can I.
I was born with everything I need to be me. Wings inside my mind to set me free. I know I've got vision more than my eyes can see. I know I rule my destiny.
So no matter how you try, no, you will never change my mind. I know if caterpillars can fly, so can I. So can I. So can I.
So can I.
Yeah.
Pleasant greetings, family, friends, members of the STAPS community, members of our board, our governing churches, and by far, greetings to class of 2021. The highlights of this academic year, for sure, surpasses those of the previous academic year. September 2020 was unlike any other year, and it started differently. We were entrenched in COVID restrictions. Instead of students walking through the gate to meet new classmates, they were instead giving out their hashtags to their Instagrams to say, follow me. For example, at Dr. Andre Dyer. There wasn't the usual anxiety of physically returning to school. Instead, there was actual genuine fear of physically being out in the open. Instead of nervous students, we had nervous parents. Regardless of the alternatives now considered the norm, class of 2021 remained unbothered. They simply adapted. Some parents could not fathom how is it that my child was unbothered at all that was going on. The class of 2021, heading into 2020, had the previous 6 months to accept the norm and adapt to the new world of virtual learning. Some students were so tuned in and so well adapted that they became instantly concerned if a teacher missed their usual posting time. Such was this new norm that if I was online, students would message me their concerns to check on a teacher. Miss so-and-so and Mr. so-and-so usually post at 4 p.m. It's now 4:15. We're wonder, have they got COVID? The tables had turned. Instead of teachers checking up on students were now checking up on teachers. Students wanted to ensure that their teachers were safe, well, and healthy. A lot of the times, my response was, your teacher just has no internet at the moment. With the elimination of physical school and extracurricular activities, students started to create new ways of socialization. What initially came across as unusual requests to administrators and teachers quickly became normal. One such request was a weekend cartoon brunch. Never heard of it. This was where students literally logged on, had lunch together, all while simply watching the same cartoon episode. This gave new meaning to lunch and a movie. Well, in this instance, cartoons. The usual requests were very, very mellow until someone had the bright idea to say, let's have a virtual party. Of course, this was widely accepted because as you know, STAPS students love to party. I still remember staying back after school ended one day to listen to a conversation about slime. Yes, slime. A full-blown conversation that was inclusive of differentiated, demonstrated techniques on how to manipulate the texture and dexterity of your slime. Yes, you caught that right. I had no idea there was so much that went into slime. And again, I was fully engaged for over 30 minutes. The pep. This was an unusual year for national exams. The frequently asked questions were, are they keeping? Is it happening? Will they happen? However, the class of 2021 still remained unbothered. So unbothered that when they briefly returned to school in January and February, they were asking me to tell their parents to dial down the anxiety a bit and just to be informed that they got this. No matter the examination that would come their way from the Ministry of Education, the class of 2021 had put in the work. They simply said, no matter what comes their way, they're prepared. In fact, they gave me some facts. Students have only missed one academic day until now. And to be honest, who wants to be at school on Friday the 13th? Our students and teachers were still able to bond, execute tasks, and meet their goals, though they were virtual. Simply because students are equally encouraged as their teachers. And together, they all knew they had this. Our students know our teachers will never ever quit on them. But now our teachers know our students will never allow them to fail, especially not to technology. the PEP results. Usually at this time of the year, we would know exactly where our students are headed off to. This time, we simply just don't know. However, I still remember a group of students walking in my direction after completing the test. One student peeled away from the pack with her face duly concerned as she approached me. Naturally, I asked, "What's wrong?" She said, "Dr. Dyer, I think I'm going to jail." I said, "What? Why?" "Because I killed it." An unexpected response followed up by, "If acing this test was a crime, they need to put me under the jail." Of course, I had to stop her with the crime jokes. And by this time, the group of students were now passing, echoing, "First choice school, Dr. Dyer. First choice school." Translation, "We did well." As odd as the lingo exchange was, I was so proud of the class of 2021. As unbothered as they were, they demonstrated they had this. But enough about the academics. Let's talk about the fun stuff. Because if you know our students, not only do they work hard, but they play hard and they compete harder. Due to social distance requirements, a number of competitions were canceled this year, such as football, netball, basketball, track and field, robotics, swimming, schools challenge quiz, table tennis, lawn tennis, just to name a few. We were understandably restricted to virtual competitions, and even some of those got canceled. But on a brighter note, students started to embrace different forms of art, such as finger painting, mandalas, perspectives, and much more. Music, speech and drama, PE, and dance. The teachers truly showed the critics that the word "can't" is not in our teachers' vocabulary when they said teaching these subjects online can't be done. The farewell. Class of 2021, everything about your final academic year has been new, strange, yet unique. Physical school I keep, then it nah keep. PEP I keep, then it nah keep. Virtual class I keep, your internet gonna sleep. Hold on, JPS, don't do it. But regardless of the circumstances, class of 2021 remained unbothered. They truly demonstrated they had this. Class of 2021, you have evolved far more than all the graduates before you. Your experience in your final year of prep school was unique, challenging, yet you remained unbothered. You have proven to be industrious, ingenious, instinctive, innovative, intuitive, inspiringly intelligent this academic year. Did you see what I did there? I'll do it again. You have demonstrated your innate, intrinsic, inherent, ingrained, infixed, and eradicable attitude of refusing to fail or quit no matter what the circumstance. And as bothered as you are, this is what makes the class of 2021 unique. Your uniqueness has highlighted the fact that you are masters of your own destiny. You have chosen to win or learn, never lose, no matter what the circumstances. All the best for the future class of 2021. Stay healthy, happy, and safe. And if people are bothered by you being unbothered, that's okay, as long as you demonstrate that you got this. Farewell, class of 2021. And to the STAPS community, stay healthy, be safe, and walk good.
I could, it's that I can. No it was Alfred North Whitehead, a British mathematician philosopher, who said, "No one who achieves success does so without acknowledging the help of others. The wise and confident acknowledge this help with gratitude." It is with this saying in mind that we pause to acknowledge the many persons behind our journey. It is indeed a privilege and an honor to represent the Grade 6 class of 2021 in acknowledging the contribution and support from all those who have seen us through to the end of our sojourn here at St. Andrew Preparatory. We are overwhelmingly grateful. Firstly, we say thanks to God for blessing us beyond measure. We pray for His continuous coverage over us as this chapter of our lives comes to a close and another looms on the horizon. We thank our principal, Dr. Andre Dyer, for his leadership during this unpredictable and challenging school year. His stewardship has inspired ingenuity and forward thinking. We are walking away with lessons of purpose and passion safely etched in our minds, being assured that we are destined for greatness. To our vice principal, Mrs. Bethenia Edwards, thank you for continuing to encourage us to strive to be our best. You have weathered many storms with us, and for that, we are grateful. The grade 6 school year is always the most nerve-wracking. Not only were we faced with the fairly new PEP exams, but also virtual school as a result of the coronavirus pandemic. Mrs. Phyllis Ramsey, Miss Suzanne Morrison, and Miss Carol McDermott, our grade 6 teachers, were our beacons of hope. Your faces and voices were what began and ended our school day. You have captained the grade 6 ship through one of the most challenging storms. Yet, you steered with love, grace, dedication, commitment, patience, and firmness. We will always hold close memories of our many talks on perseverance, forgiveness, humility, and honesty. May God bless you all. Then, there are other teachers who have been with us from K-1 to grade 5. How can we adequately say thank you? You have laid the foundation of our knowledge, and because of you, we will continue to excel. We promise to live and lead by the principles of the core values of this noble institution, deeply entrenched in our minds, that of commitment, discipline, honesty, integrity, and respect. We want to also acknowledge and say thank you to the members of the Creative Arts team. With true love and passion for your craft, you have helped us to discover and unlock our talents. Your invaluable input in preparing us for this ceremony has affirmed for us what you have always known. We are resilient and ready to soar. We will miss you, but we take comfort in the knowledge, knowing that you will continue to raise the bar of excellence at St. Andrew Preparatory and encourage your students to give off their best. You have indeed made our years at STAPS unforgettable. Thank you. To our unsung heroes, the members of the administrative staff, the ancillary and canteen staff, and security personnel, we not only thank you for the various roles you played in making this ceremony a success, but also for your support throughout our tenure at the school. Your dedication to service has afforded for us a school environment that was always welcoming and a safe haven while on school campus. Special thanks to our school chaplains who have blessed us at this function. Monday mornings were something to look forward to when you shared them with us at our devotions when we met in the physical space. Heartiest of thanks to our guest speaker and former principal, Mrs. Janice Walsh Davis. We are indeed grateful that you took the time to share in this momentous occasion. Your message was inspiring and thought-provoking. We will take your advice on the next leg of our journey. Last, but by no means least, we must thank our parents, guardians, well-wishers, and friends who have weathered this storm with us. With you constantly cheering for us, we remain confident knowing that we can only soar for greater greatness. We thank everyone who is watching from the safety of his or her home. We hope that this family prayers was as enjoyable for you as it was for us. Long may we continue to live our school motto, work, play, and learn together.
Welcome one and all to family prayers. Let us bow our heads for prayer. God, our strength and our hope, we give you thanks and praise for taking us through another academic year. We are so happy that despite the challenges of a pandemic, you have preserved us for this moment. Thank you that you have placed us in families who care for us and help us to have an identity and sense of belonging. Thank you for our school community that exposes us to new learning, to empower us, and open up windows of opportunity to broaden our view of the world and inspire us to soar to new heights of achievement each day. Thank you for our church family that helped to shape our values so that we may know the joy of human love and human relationships. Thank you for Jesus Christ, who lived and died and rose again to save us from sin. Thank you that he is the pattern of our lives and who shows us how to live to fulfill our purpose in you. Thank you for the Bible that teaches us how to be resilient in adversity. Thank you that when we read and obey your word, we experience Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. And we also experience his peace, his joy, and love, your gifts of abundant living. We pray for your blessing upon all in the educational process. The Ministry of Education, the local school board, principal, teachers, parents and guardians, ancillary staff, that they may remain loving and united in you. Bless them with tolerance and vision that as they seek through various means to make our school a better place, they may work together to achieve great things together and so make our school, our community, and our country a better environment within which to live. Bless our proceedings this evening, that all will go well, and that your name may be glorified. We ask these prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our supreme example for living, and the hope for the future life in eternity with you. Amen.
Jerusalema, ikayalami, ilondoloze, uhambe nami, zungangishilana. Jerusalema, ikayalami, ilondoloze, uhambe nami, zungangishilana. Daoyami, alikolana, buso wami, aukolana. Ilondoloze, zuhambe nami. Daoyami, alikolana, buso wami, aukolana. Aikolana, buso wami, aukolana. Kilondolose, zuhambe nami. Dawo yami, aikolana, buso wami, aukolana. Kilondolose.
This used to be my childhood dream. This used Those are words I never say.